Om Namah Shivaya. Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about the submandibular ganglion. And the submandibular ganglion also called Langlis ganglion. Okay, Langlis ganglion. Submandibular ganglion is a parasympathetic ganglion which serves as a relay station for secretomotor fibers supplying the submandibular and sublingual salivary glands. It is a parasympathetic ganglion which serves as a relay station for secretomotor fiber supplying the submandibular and sublingual salivary glands. Topographically, it is connected to the trigeminal nerve, that is lingual nerve, but functionally it is related to the facial nerve through its cauda tympani branch. Next, the location of the submandibular ganglion. And this submandibular ganglion is of the size of a pinhead and situated on the outer surface of the higher glossus muscle. It is suspended from lingual nerve by 2 wicks. The proximal wick is afferent to the ganglion and the distal root is efferent to the ganglion. Next, relations of the submandibular ganglion. Above lingual nerve, below deep part of submandibular gland, and next medial higher glossus muscle and lateral submandibular gland. It is superficial. See once again relations of the submandibular ganglion. Above lingual nerve, below deep part of the submandibular gland and medial higher glossus muscle and lateral submandibular gland, that is superficial. And the superficial part of the submandibular gland lies lateral to the submandibular ganglion. See this figure. This figure represents the relations of the submandibular ganglion. Okay. See here. This is the submandibular ganglion. And the relations of the submandibular ganglion are above lingual nerve. See above, below. Okay, above, below, and this is the medial and this is the lateral. Okay, see one by one. First, above to submandibular ganglion, lingual nerve is present, and below to the submandibular ganglion, deep part of mandibular gland is present. Deep part of the submandibular gland is present, and next, medially, see here. Medially, higher glossus is present. See here, this is the medial. Okay, this is the medial. And next, laterally, superficial part of submandibular gland is present. See here, this is the lateral. Laterally, superficial part of submandibular gland is present. Okay, see once again. Above to submandibular ganglion, lingual nerve is present. Below to the ganglion, deep part of submandibular gland is present. And next, medially, higher glossus muscle is present. And laterally, superficial part of submandibular gland is present. These are the relations of the submandibular ganglion. Next, roots of the submandibular ganglion. Next, roots of the submandibular ganglion. The submandibular ganglion has 3 roots, parasympathetic, sympathetic, and sensory. First, parasympathetic root of submandibular ganglion. Parasympathetic root, and it is derived from lingual nerve. The preganglionic fibers arise from superior salivary nucleus situated in the pons and pass successively through the facial nerve, cauda tympani and lingual nerves to reach the ganglion where they relay. The postganglionic fibers arise from ganglion and directly supply the gland. See once again the parasympathetic root of the submandibular ganglion. And the parasympathetic ganglion, parasympathetic root is derived from lingual nerve. Clear? It is derived from the lingual nerve. And the preganglionic fibers arise from superior salivary nucleus. Preganglionic fibers arise from superior salivary nucleus, and these situated in the pons and pass successively through facial nerve, caudal tympani, lingual nerves to reach the ganglion where they relay. These preganglionic fibers reach the ganglion and they relay. And the postganglionic fibers arise from ganglion and directly supply the gland. See this figure. This figure represents the submandibular ganglion roots or connections. Okay, this represents the connections of the submandibular ganglion. Okay, first about the parasympathetic roots. These parasympathetic roots derive from the lingual nerve. Okay guys, these parasympathetic root derive from the lingual nerve. First see the preganglionic fibers. The preganglionic fibers arise from the superior salivary nucleus. See here, this is the preganglionic fibers. See here, these are the preganglionic fibers. These preganglionic fibers arise from the superior salivary nucleus and these arise from the pons. And these preganglionic fibers pass successively through facial nerve. See here, and this continues and passes successively through next facial nerve. Next, caudal tympani. See here, caudal tympani, and next lingual nerve. And they relay into the submandibular ganglion. See here, this is the submandibular ganglion. And from submandibular ganglion, postganglionic fibers arise. From submandibular ganglion, postganglionic fibers arise and they supply directly the gland. Okay, see here, the postganglionic fibers arise from the submandibular ganglion and this directly supplies the submandibular gland. This is about the parasympathetic root of submandibular gland. These parasympathetic root arise from the superior salivary nucleus and pass successively through the facial nerve, caudal tympani nerve and lingual nerve and relay into the submandibular ganglion. And the fibers and from submandibular ganglion, postganglionic fibers arise and they supply directly this submandibular gland. This is about the parasympathetic root. Next, sympathetic root of the submandibular gland. It is derived from sympathetic fluxes around the facial artery. The preganglionic fibers arise from the first thoracic spinal segment, that is T1, and enter the cervical sympathetic chain to relay in superior ganglion. The postganglionic fibers arise from the superior cervical sympathetic ganglion, form fluxes around the facial artery to pass through ganglion without relay and supply the blood vessels in the submandibular and sublingual salivary glands. See once again the sympathetic root, and the sympathetic root derived from sympathetic fluxes around the facial artery. The preganglionic fibers arise from the first thoracic spinal segment, that is T1, and enter the cervical sympathetic chain to relay in the superior ganglion. The postsympathetic fibers arise from the superior cervical sympathetic ganglion, form fluxes around the facial artery to pass through the ganglion without relay and pass and supply the blood vessels in the submandibular and sublingual salivary glands. Next, sensory root. It is derived from the lingual nerve. Sensory root of submandibular gland derived from lingual nerve. See the figure. See here, this is the sympathetic root of the submandibular gland. This is the sympathetic root of the submandibular ganglion, okay? And this in sympathetic root, the preganglionic fibers arise from the T1 segment. See here, this is the origin, and the T1 segment of spinal cord. These preganglionic fibers arise from the T1 segment of the spinal cord, and these enter the cervical sympathetic chain to relay in superior ganglion, okay, and to relay in the superior ganglion, and from the post ganglion, and from here, see here, and from here the superior cervical sympathetic ganglion arises, and from here this is the superior cervical sympathetic ganglion. The post ganglionic fibers arise from the superior cervical sympathetic ganglion and form the sympathetic flux, see here, and form the sympathetic flux around the facial artery. This is the facial artery, and the sympathetic flux is formed around the facial artery, and without relaying into the submandibular ganglion. See here, without relaying into the submandibular ganglion, this sympathetic root supplies the blood vessels or vasomotor fibers to the submandibular and sublingual glands. This postsympathetic fibers, without relaying in the submandibular ganglion, directly supplies the vasomotor fibers or blood vessels of submandibular or sublingual glands. This is about the sympathetic root. See here, without relaying. This is relaying. This directly coming, that is, it is not relaying. Next, sensory root, and sensory root, sensory fibers reach the ganglion through the lingual nerve. In submandibular ganglion, sensory root derived from the lingual nerve. Next, branches of the submandibular ganglion. The branches of the submandibular ganglion are 5 to 6 branches which supply the submandibular gland, and other fibers join the lingual nerve to supply the sublingual and anterior lingual glands. The branches of the submandibular ganglion, 5 to 6 branches which supply the submandibular gland, and other fibers joining the lingual nerve to supply the sublingual and anterior lingual glands. This is about the submandibular ganglion. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.